Don't give me, huh?
Yeah, what did you say about my 5-year-old?
Your 5-year-old is under your cover because she's not of age. Yeah, Ariana and Kyla, they are of age to decide which way you want to go. But your baby 5, she's under your cover right now. So the demons don't have a legal right to remain in her because of your cover. So this is what I want you to do. Do you have a bottle of olive oil?
Yes, I do.
Let's go get that bottle of olive oil.
I got them. I have two small ones.
Good, great, great. I want you to keep it up, and I'm going to pray that the Father saturate his presence in it, and then I'm going to give you instructions, okay?
Okay.
Okay. So, Father, I just thank you for this opportunity. I just thank you, Lord, for my dear sister, Carla. Father, I thank you. As I'm hearing you say to her, he got this. Carla, Lord, just said he got this.
Thank you.
You know what that means? Yeah. He said, I got this.
Yeah.
You know, Satan, you know, just like with Jesus, Satan just knew he had an upper hand on Jesus. He thought he was killing him. Didn't know he was falling right into the Father's plan.
Yes.
But the Lord said, he got it, God. He got it.
Okay.
So he said, you stand and watch the salvation of the Lord. You're going to watch God's work, and he's going to work. And your two daughters will come running to you like my daughter came running to me. They're going to come running to you. Mama, help. And that's your cute girl that them devils come out. But God, so much he got you. So, Father, I just thank you. And I thank you for blessing my dear sister and her family, keeping them safe from the evil one, Lord. For their house shall be known as a house of peace. The Prince of Peace survives in that house. Father, you know, I just thank you for what you're about to do in Victoria. The devil is tormenting Victoria, and she falls under her mother's covering. And I thank you, Lord, for giving her wisdom and insight, Lord, to keep her little girl clean in your eyesight. And Father, as you have done in times past, when your servant Paul asked you to anoint the handkerchiefs and aprons of the people in whom he was not able to lay hands on all of them because it was so many, and you've done so. Because when he gave the handkerchiefs and aprons back to the people, your word tell us that those that had devils and sicknesses, they left. Why? Because your presence saturated those aprons and handkerchiefs. Father, Carl and I is in agreement right now that you also saturate that oil with your presence, Father. That whatsoever it comes in contact with, Father, if devils are there, sickness, disease, or whatever,
thank you, Jesus.
They have to go. And I thank you, Father, in Jesus' name. Glory to your holy name. All right, now, Carla, this is what I want you to do. I want you to open one of the bottle of oil.
Okay.
First, I want you to anoint your forehead, put your finger in it, and anoint your forehead. Because God is anointing you for this service, okay?
Okay.
Because I'm not physically able to be there.
Okay.
Now I want you to drink a little.
Okay.
And I want you to call Victoria. Call Victoria. And I said a little.
I said a little.
It tastes nasty, but it doesn't bother you.
Amen. Victoria, come here, honey.
And see if she would drink a little and then take it and not her forehead, but see if she might not drink it because it's so nasty.
Come here. I have Evangelist King here.
Hey, baby.
She said hi.
She's so cute. She's my grandbaby.
She said you're so cute. You remind her of her grandbaby.
Victoria.
She can't hear because I got the earphones in. She said, hi, Victoria.
Hi.
You want to put it in your ear?
Put it in her ear. Hi, Victoria.
Hi.
Oh, you are so cute.
Thank you.
So cute. Praise the Lord. Amen. Thank you, Lord, for perfect teeth. Got your teeth out. It's coming back. So brand new teeth is coming back. Glory to God. So could you drink a little bit of that oil for us? Victoria, just a little. You don't have to drink a lot. I know, baby. Can you just drink a little bit?
A little bit.
Just a little tiny bit. That's all it takes. Okay. All right. Ooh, all right. Okay. Mama trying to keep you alive. All right. not her forehead in Jesus' name.
Okay.
Amen. Amen. Mm-hmm. Now I want you to take and call, put it on your hands and rub your hands.
Okay.
Rub your hand with God's presence. You know, put the oil down.
Okay.
Amen. Amen.
I got I have the attic. I have a basement.
I know.
Two regular floors. So am I gonna need more?
No, God presence is right there in your hand. You don't need no more.
Okay. Yeah.
Now, but first we're gonna anoint Victoria because I want Victoria to agree. It's nothing like a child coming in agreement in God's word because their faith, girl, whew, they believe. So we're gonna have Victoria to walk around with you as well.
All right. So,
what I want you to, Colin, I want you to lay hands on Victoria.
Okay.
Would you lay
on her head?
Yeah, your right hand on her head like this here.
My right hand, okay.
Right. Mm-hmm. And then I want you to repeat after me because that is your child and you have the authority.
Okay.
I want you to say every, and I want you to mean this, and I want you to target those spirits. If you know what your daughter has been tormenting, how the devil tormented her in the dream.
Mm-hmm.
And in the physical too, the devil is tormenting her. So you targeting those spirits. So you say every spirit.
Every spirit.
Not of the Holy Spirit.
Not of the Holy Spirit.
I command you in Jesus' name.
I command you in Jesus' name.
To come out of her.
To come out of her.
Come out of her mind.
Come out of her mind.
Loose her mind.
Loose her mind.
The blood of Jesus commands you.
The blood of Jesus commands you.
In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
Turn loose her will.
Turn loose her will.
Turn it loose.
Turn it loose.
In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
And get out.
And get out.
Come out of her emotions.
Out of her emotions.
Come out now.
Come out now.
Gather all your loads.
Gather all your loads.
All your things you put in her mind.
All your things you put in her mind.
Get out.
Get out.
Get out.
Get out.
Out in Jesus.
Out in Jesus'
name. For the
name.
Blood of Jesus commands you.
For the blood of Jesus commands you.
And you get out of her body.
And you get out of her body.
Everything you put on her body.
Everything you put on her body.
And in her body.
And in her body.
In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
I command you.
I command you.
To come out.
Come out.
Now.
Now.
Put your hand on her belly. Come out. Out. Out.
Come out. 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 Out.
Out in Jesus' name. The blood of Jesus commands you. Put your hand on her private area. Come out. Come out.
Come out. Come out. Come out. Come out.
Out in Jesus' name. Put your hand on her rectum. Out in Jesus' name.
Out in Jesus' name.
Out in Jesus' name. On her eyes. Put it on her eyes. Out in Jesus' name. In her ears and nose and mouth. Out in Jesus' name. For the blood of Jesus commands you. The blood of Jesus commands
you. Out.
Holy Ghost, I call upon you.
I call upon you.
To search and destroy darkness.
Search and destroy darkness.
They're still trying to linger and hold on to.
Still trying to linger and hold on to Victoria.
Her mind.
Her mind.
Her will.
Her will.
Her emotions.
Her emotions.
And her body.
And her body.
Holy Ghost, burn.
Holy Ghost, burn.
Everything that's not of you.
Everything that is not
from the crown of her head,
from the crown of her
head, to the soles of her feet,
to the soles of her feet,
do a clean sweep, Holy Ghost.
Do a clean sweep, Holy Ghost.
In Jesus' mighty name.
In Jesus' mighty name.
In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
Holy Ghost fire burn.
Holy Ghost fire burn.
Every mark.
Every mark.
That was made.
That was made.
In and on her body.
In and on her body.
Burn those evil marks.
Burn those evil marks.
Holy Ghost fire burn.
Holy Ghost fire burn.
That body piercing.
That body piercing.
Tattoo covenant in the spirit realm.
Tattoo covenant in the spirit realm.
Burn Holy Ghost.
Burn Holy Ghost.
By faith in Jesus' name.
By faith in Jesus' name.
I disconnect her.
I disconnect her.
From every. Ungodly covenant.
Ungodly covenant.
Idolatry and witchcraft.
Idolatry and witchcraft.
In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
By faith in the spirit.
By faith in the spirit.
I disconnect her.
I disconnect her.
From you, spirit husband.
Yes, from you, spirit husband.
Spirit wife.
Spirit wife.
Spirit children.
Spirit children.
The entire spirit family.
The entire spirit family.
Every relationship in the spirit realm.
Every relationship in the spirit
realm. My heavenly Father did not connect her to.
My my Heavenly Father did not connect her to,
I disconnect.
I disconnect.
In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
For the blood of Jesus.
For the blood of Jesus.
Disconnects her.
Disconnects her.
And sets her totally free by his shed blood.
And sets her totally free by his shed blood.
Even in this natural realm.
Even in this natural realm.
Every relationship. My Heavenly Father did not connect her to.
My Heavenly Father did not connect her to.
I disconnect.
I disconnect.
I disconnect.
I disconnect.
I disconnect.
I disconnect.
In Jesus' mighty
in
name.
In Jesus' mighty name.
Thank you, Father.
Thank you, Father.
Fill her.
Fill her.
To overflow.
To overflow.
With your spirit.
With your spirit.
Fill her mind.
Fill her mind.
Her will.
Her will.
Her emotions.
Her emotions.
Her dreams.
Her dreams.
Her visions.
Her visions.
Her business, which soon will be her career.
Her business, her career.
In her affairs.
In her affairs.
In her body.
In her body.
With your spirit, Father.
With your spirit, Father.
In Jesus' mighty name.
In Jesus' mighty name.
Thank you, Father.
Thank you, Father.
For placing a hedge of protection around her wherever she goes.
For placing a hedge of protection around wherever she goes.
Thank you for her linking angels that protect her.
Thank you for her linking angels that protect her.
Thank you, Father.
Thank you, Father.
Say, I want you to put the camera down and look in Victoria's face. Look in her face. Say, Victoria. Say, yes. Victoria.
Oh, Victoria.
Be free.
Be free.
Say, mine.
Mine.
Be free.
Be free.
Will.
Will.
Be free.
Be free.
Emotion.
Emotion.
Be free.
Be free.
And body.
And body.
Be free.
Be free.
In Jesus' mighty name.
In Jesus' mighty name.
Be free.
Be free.
Amen. 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 Victoria, you are free, baby. Amen. Amen. She's free.
Yeah,
you know, wasn't she yawning? I heard those yawns.
Yeah, she did yawn a few times.
Those spirits were coming out. The camera was paying down.
My eyes was closed and I wasn't looking at you.
And I heard the Lord say, see, I'm casting those spirits. I hear that yawn. Those demons were going out by the yawn. I heard about two or three times.
She
is free. So she's under your cover. Now, as I learned this to do this by example of my own grandchild.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not my grandchild's mother, so I'm not her covering.
Right.
But God honored my prayer.
Mm-hmm.
Her mother actually is her covering, so I had to teach the mother. Lord told me to teach her mother. So mm-hmm. I said, Miriam, I said, you need to do this deliverance on Janelle. And I shared with you how, well, she listened to me so many times, so I didn't have to tell her how to do it because she already knew.
Right.
I said, but Janelle needs to be delivered. You the mother, so you have to deliver her. So she delivered her. So and sure enough, you know, demon manifested.
Oh wow.
In this case, it wasn't through the yarn, it was she didn't want to do it. She was like, see, that's the demon. That's the fine spirit. But it had to come out. The demon came out. So I said, Mira, now, since she goes to daycare. And since she used her iPad to watch those cartoons, with nothing wrong with those cartoons she watched, but the problem come in, since many of the people watch those cartoons, they have incorporated those ads. That's where they get their money.
Right, yeah.
And those ads, we found out, are demonic.
Mm-hmm.
And Satan used that to infiltrate the child's mind. But my daughter was wondering, well, mama, you know, how is she picking up these spirits? Quite naturally, she could get them from school too because of her classmate parents not raping them.
Mm-hmm.
But Mira keeps her cover with that. But she was unaware of those ads, and Lord told me those ads. And one day, when she was watching that cartoon, an ad jumped up and she screamed. And Mira went, and it was a demonic ad. And the Lord showed her. So I told her, I said, well, you might want to. I found out through my husband on YouTube, you can purchase for $10 a month to watch YouTube without ads. Okay. If you got children who got iPads, you may want to do that.
Mm-hmm.
And also, mm-hmm. I told her it's very important since she goes to daycare, and you never know how the enemy will his way in. It's good to do a deliverance on her once a month.
Mm-hmm.
Just like you, mm-hmm. just like you just did. Do that mm-hmm. once a month. Now you see how that didn't incorporate fear in her. Now if you wow. calling out demon name, howling and yelling, the devil would have used fear.
Yeah. So I can't imagine doing that to a child.
You have to treat underage children differently. Now when it's a child who of age, that's totally different.
Right.
But underage children, you can't do that. You say every spirit, not the Holy
Spirit.
Okay. Now, that different spirit. Keep them back. But do it once a month, and you continue to keep Ariana and Kyla in prayer.
Okay, yeah.
And let them see Jesus Christ through your actions and your reactions. Okay.
Mm-hmm. Now, I just want to say too, Evangelist King, that mm-hmm. I kind of blame myself for that, because it wasn't an accident that when you did my deliverance, you asked me, you said, "Are you married?" Then I said, "Yes." And you said, "Well, are you and your husband still together?" And I say, "Yes." But at the time, my husband and we wasn't sleeping together.
Mm-hmm.
I was in another room. He was in one room. And to make a long story short, we had not been together, intimately in a long time. And that caused, there was already strife and division mm-hmm. in my house. Mm-hmm. But that caused it more so. So after the deliverance, I was able to see I was being deceived, because I felt like God was saying, okay, leave him, get out of the room, don't, be with him anymore, that type of thing. But now I see that, that wasn't God. That wasn't him saying that.
Mm-hmm.
And so my children saw that. But once I went back into the room with him, they felt like I'm back on his side and that type of thing. So, because mm-hmm. it's a lot going on.
You see, now, other words, yeah. So your children watch your session and they heard you say no.
No, they didn't watch my one daughter, Kyla, she watched only a part of it. I guess she didn't want to see the whole thing. Mm-hmm. And my other daughter, she didn't watch it at all.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so it's not that they saw the session, they just saw my action. Like I said, I have been out of the room.
Okay, they saw your action.
Months and months. Yes, mm-hmm. they saw that. Mm-hmm. And then, my husband is his demeanor. He's like very, I don't want to talk about him, because their personalities clash. Let me say it like that. And mm-hmm. so they felt like, okay, now that I'm, back in here with him, now I'm going to be on his side. And it's not like I told you, it's already division already in my house before I left. But I messed up by leaving, and it made it worse.
Yeah, it made it worse.
Back. Yeah.
See, mm-hmm. that's the reason why, I tell a lot mm-hmm. of married women, men too, but mainly with women, you don't preach to your husband with it. It's through your actions and reactions.
Mm-hmm.
Your children, your children always look at the mother. Regardless of what that father do, the children just look at that mother.
Mm-hmm.
Watch the mother mm-hmm. action and reaction.
Mm-hmm.
And how the mother react and act, that's how the children will be. So that's how you're going to win them, is let them see Jesus Christ through your actions and your reaction. And as you mm-hmm. do that, the Holy Ghost is going to convict them. Because as mm-hmm. I told them, I'm about to shed tears. I wish I have known a woman of God like myself or you mm-hmm. when I was 14, 19, that would have delivered me. Those spirits was in me. Those sets were mm-hmm. in me. And I need to be there. And see, they know truth. They know truth now. Mm-hmm. They blatantly have refused to be delivered. So now that torment will be in work. But the good thing about it, God is not going to let that Satan take their life.
Mm-hmm.
Not unless they can do that. It's because of your prayer.
Yeah,
because of prayer, you keep upholding them in prayer. They're not going to be able to sleep in peace, be in peace.
Mm-hmm.
It's because they have rejected God. And they're going to mm-hmm. come run to you crying. Just like my daughter. Look at me. I knew my daughter would help. Here I am. Holy Ghost Fire Deliverance meeting. And she's helping me out.
Mm-hmm.
And here I'm doing a deliverance session. And she committing fornication. And I knew it. Mm-hmm. But I had to act like I didn't know.
Mm-hmm.
The Lord said, don't say nothing, nothing you can do. She has to decide for herself.
Okay.
Because she's of age. So my heart went out in prayer for her. I just, Lord, help me to accept the way you do this. But I kept on, kept my faith strong in the Lord. I showed her through my action and reaction. She even confessed to me. She said, Mama, she said, one time you were going down the stairs, I was behind you. That spirit told me to push you down the stairs. And I said, I'm not going to push my mama down the stairs. She said, Mama, I couldn't stand to hear you talk. She didn't hardly communicate with me. She didn't want to talk to me. She said, I couldn't stand it. She's, but now, Mom, as my deliverance, I love her. Sometimes I'm trying to get rid of her. I love
her. That's good.
Yeah, yeah.
The Lord turned that around.
He, wow, yeah, he turned that thing around.
He did, yeah.
That devil, because that, when she got pregnant, found she was pregnant, and told that boy, and the Lord convicted her that she couldn't have that boy and him too. And it was a tough decision. And you know, the devil was telling her to kill the baby and everything. And the Lord was telling me all of this was going on. She was out about with our second daughter. And I was at home. And I knew all that was going on. And then later I got a phone call from my second daughter and said, Mommy, Mama, talk to me because she's talking about killing herself. I said, okay. So she, I act like I didn't know what was going on. So she came home. She came in the back where I was at in my office. Before she could get out, she said, she didn't even get it out. But I knew. Because she couldn't get out. I said, in Jesus' name, cut her. I went like a lunatic girl. That was my daughter.
I know that's right. Yeah.
That was a crazy woman. You ain't seen the man. I was crazy. That was my daughter. The devil talking about killing herself. That was my first grandbaby. Girl, I went off on the devil. You cut her. No. She's not a spec kid. Cut out. You won't have no nigga right. Cut out. Just, no. She wants back. She that girl, that thing. It let her back in. It wanted her. Wanted them and everything. But I know that spirit came out. She's been faithful to God ever since. So you just show through your actions and your reaction. Regardless how your husband eliminates that demon spirit through him, not him. He really loves.
Yeah, I know.
But when spirits are in a person, it's them who don't love. And you can feel when they speak through them that hate. Chills up your body. You be like,
yeah,
cringe. He's like, that is not my husband. That is not my wife. And that's when you smile at your spouse, go in the bathroom and say, go back down in Jesus' name.
Okay.
Spirit wife, spirit husband, get back down there in Jesus' name. Then you come back and smile again at your spouse. Same thing with your children. Now you may see those spirits really be acting Ariana and Kyle. Even worse now. Same thing with them. You do the same thing. You gotta remember now, you are the head of that house, you and your husband, not your children.
Right, yeah.
They have to obey your rule. It's what you say. They is under your roof. Your children will try you when they get of age. They will try you. Don't think you got to walk on pins and needles. That you won't upset them, get them upset. No, that is your house. You and your husband's house. You don't walk on no pins and needles. You know what I'm saying? Some parents do that. You have to be quiet. I don't want you to disturb my daughter, my son. Like they the head of that house. Devil is a liar. You are.
Yeah.
Glory to God. So now, okay, since we talked so long, take and put some more oil on your hand. And we go about the house.
All right.
Thank you, Father.
Okay.
Just take the phone with you and go everywhere the Holy Ghost tells you to come.
Okay, I'm starting.
So Father, we just thank you.
Oh.
So in Jesus' mighty name, just go about.
Start touching. Okay.
In Jesus' name, I command every spirit not of the Holy Spirit to get out. You have no legal right in Carla's house. For the blood of Jesus commands you. Just as the Father refused to coexist with you in his house, so does Carla refuse to coexist with you in her house. Get out! All of you, pack your loads and get out. For the blood of Jesus commands you. The Father said, whatsoever I bind and loose on this earth will be bound and loose in the heaven. I bind you, every spirit, not a Holy Spirit, and I cast you out. Now, Holy Ghost, go in every corner, crack, and crevice of the house and destroy darkness. Destroy darkness that hovers in every room, in every bedroom, around the bed, the foot of the bed, the front of the bed, under the bed, the top of the bed, in between your sheets and the mattress, and destroy dark. Destroy dark that's hiding in the wall, in the ceilings, in the floor. Go in every closed space, every closet, and destroy dark. Leave no space untouched in her house. Holy Ghost fire, consume them all, consume them all, consume them all by your mighty fire. Fire the Holy Ghost, burn, burn everything that's not you. For this house shall be known as a house of peace. The Prince of Peace resides in this house. Holy Ghost fire, destroy spirits of division, spirit of strife, spirits of anger, spirits of hatefulness, rage. Burn, Holy Ghost. Set them all ablaze, set them all ablaze, Holy Ghost. Go, Holy Ghost, around every window sill, every door. Burn, Holy Ghost, burn. By faith in Jesus' name, I break every mirror that is a portal. I break it and seal it with the blood of Jesus. Holy Ghost, fire, burn every object that has been planted in that house, known or unknown to God. Burn those evil objects. Burn. Go in every electronic device. Go in every appliance. Burn, Holy Ghost, all that's not me. Burn on every furniture. Burn, Holy Ghost. Don't leave nothing untouched, Holy Ghost. Burn, burn in Jesus' name. Even go outside the house. Burn spirits of darkness that resides around the house, under the house, even underground and over the house. Burn, Holy Ghost. Throughout their properties, Holy Ghost, burn those squatting spirit. Burn squatting, burn those monitoring spirit. I pluck their eyes out in Jesus' mighty name. Holy Ghost fire, continue to ransack the house. Make that house a Prince of Peace. The Prince of Peace resides in this house. Holy Ghost fire, destroy even again the object that the demons feel they have legal right to be at. Destroy those evil objects, known or unknown to them. Burn, 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 burn. Consume them all. Consume them all in Jesus' mighty name. Continue, Holy Ghost. Leave no area untouched by your consuming fire. Burn, for this house is known as the Prince of Peace. Holy Ghost fire, whoever walks through them doors, let them feel the very presence of God. The Prince of Peace resides in that house. Burn, Holy Ghost. Burn, burn, Holy Ghost. Continue to consume darkness hiding in the closet, under the beds. Burn. Burn, Holy Ghost. Burn, burn, Holy Ghost, in Jesus' mighty name. Holy Ghost fire, whoever walks through that door, convict them of sin, righteousness, and judgment in Jesus' mighty name. Holy Ghost fire, let the blood of Jesus pour down the windowsill, down the wall, the ceiling, the floor, outside the house, on top of the house, down the sides of the house. Just cover her, all her property, in the blood of Jesus, in Jesus. Soak it in the blood of Jesus. Wash it, rinse it, baptize it in the blood of Jesus, in Jesus' mighty name. In Jesus' name. For Father, you said, whatever we bind and loose on this earth, you bind and you loose in heaven. And we thank you, Father, for cleaning your house. And we thank you for cleaning Carla's house. Thank you, Jesus. For this house now is known as a house of peace. The Prince of Peace resides in that house. Thank you, Father, in Jesus' mighty name. We sing glory to your holy name. We sing praises to you, Lord. We thank you, Lord Jesus. Now, Carla, I need you to go to the front door.
Yes, okay.
Open that front door. You know how when you invited people in, you let them out? Nope, you just open the door and say, bye-bye.
Bye-bye in Jesus' name. Get out in Jesus' name. Don't come back.
Amen.
In the name of
Jesus' name. And close that door. Keep your house clean, girl.
Yes.
Keep it clean. And continue to ask the Holy Spirit if there are any objects there that the Father is not pleased of it. Just reveal it to you and you just get it on out. That's what your children say. Said, no, it's not staying in my house.
Yes.
It separates us from the presence of God. Get your own house and you bring your own things in your house.
Mm-hmm.
Glory to God.
Amen.
I'm telling you now, we got grown children and they had lived with us, and you have to let them know who is in control here, because they will try to control. It's those spirits in them try to control.
Yes.
So God's gonna hold you and your husband responsible. Right. What goes on in your house?
Mm-hmm.
Praise the Lord God. It is done. It is finished. In Jesus' name. And remember now, once a month, you do that deliverance on Victoria. What's
up? Okay. You know, all right, I will do that.
It looks so cute on the outside, Karen. My window was so cute on the outside. My daughter told me, said, Mama, she said, my baby was so cute on the outside. She said, but when I did that deliverance, that spirit manifest, Mama, I almost got scared. I did not like what I saw.
Oh,
I didn't live with that spirit. See how it can be so cute on the outside, on the inside. The devil could be in there. They're not cute.
You don't even know it. Wow.
You don't even know it. So looking out on how cute they is. And I thank God for your, oh God, girl, you don't know how God is smiling at you.
Amen. Thank you.
Your obedience to God and being obedient to his instruction about your children. Because my heart right now saddens me, and I'm hoping God will tune this lady in to this session. Because God had delivered her, he wanted to deliver her children. But she is the one who did not want them on camera. She's the one.
Yeah.
You see, the different thing when it's the child, but the mother is the one who don't want no child. Okay, did she not know she had traded for her children not being on camera, traded their souls for them not being on camera? She don't really know what danger she got her children in by refusing to teach them to even give up their reputation. Because I'm telling you, right now, if their friends say, come on, you know, there's a possibility we can go viral on YouTube or Facebook. Girl, they'll make that video right
quick. They sure will, yeah.
Yes, they will.
Mm-hmm.
But when it comes down to things of God, no. For sure, it's that defiant spirit. So I'm hoping that woman is watching because God's going to hold her accountable for her children. She don't want them to be on camera. Hey, get my children free. I'll put them on, if I had them underage, I'll put them on camera to get set free.
Yeah.
Now something different. If you want them, put them on camera, do something bad, then no, you don't do it. But this is something good. You're gonna have to. But can't you just do out of there? Yeah, I can, but it's not gonna help you. You still hold on to your reputation by doing the video. Then there's something that won't do the audio. It's teaching you to give up your reputation. Self got to die. You have to give up everything for God. You're on Facebook posting pictures. You ain't ashamed. You're not ashamed. But when it comes down to do something for God, no, it's that defiant spirit. No. Lord, I'm willing to give up everything for you, even my own reputation. And that's why God is smiling at you. And again, I pray that he's sending that other woman to see this, because she is the one who, in her heart, don't want her children to be on camera. And because of that, the demons have returned in her. So that's disobedience. You see? So you heard that. I'm not calling out your name. You know who you are. You're obedient to the law. Give up that reputation. Who are we? Who are we? Who are we? Give us law.
Yeah, I was asking the Lord about pride, and one of the definitions he gave me was pride is you thinking, caring more about what man thinks than you do about what God thinks. He just made it simple for me. That's what pride is.
That's
so he said, anytime you caring more about what, you know, your family think or people at your job, whoever thinks more than what you care about what
that
I think. He said, Carla, you in pride.
See, you're in pride.
Okay, Lord.
See, that's pride. And that's why a lot of people don't want to be on audio and video is because of pride, because they care more about what other people may think of them than God. That's pride.
Right.
I don't care. I finally gave in and said, I love Jesus. Lord, tell me, share my testimony. I said, yes, Lord. And when I first shared the call, I was hurting. I was sharing it, but I was hurting. But you know, the more I shared it, the more I told it and shared it, that hurt finally went completely away. Because I'm telling you, I did some things that I said, oh, my children never knew about this. Really, it was my intention never my children ever to know I had sex before marriage. That was never my intention. And ever find it out, I was never ever planning on telling them that. Because I was so ashamed. And I'm taught to not have sex before marriage. And I held on, and I met my husband, which was an unhealthy relationship. And I pulled away from God, made him God, and we sinned. Mm-hmm. And my intention was never to let my children die. And the devil, through my mother, told my children. But I had to finally confess to them. And that thing was hurt. Tell my children. My husband, the only man I ever been with, but still, we had sex before marriage.
Oh, okay.
It don't matter, he's the only man I ever been with. We sinned. I sinned against my body by having sex before marriage. And I had to confess to that, and that thing hurt me. I loved Jesus, and I had to willingly give up my reputation. Mm-hmm. And not alone, letting everybody else know in some of the things that I've done. That's why I want Ariana and Kyla, if you'll get delivered from these demon spirits, of sexual demons, they come in abundance. You have sex outside of marriage, and after a while, you find yourself being attracted to the same sex.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Find yourself being attracted to the same sex. Mm-hmm. That comes in with time, when you need to be delivered. And you continue to keep them in prayer. Remember, God is smiling, and I just smile. And your baby, Victoria, she's so sweet.
Thank you.
He is free. I just love the way the Lord just delivered that little baby. God delivered children.
Yes.
And he's so good.
He is.
Now, to you parents who say you want your children delivered, then you must too first be delivered. Mm. Because your children, the underage children, deliver the title of your deliverance.
Mm.
You see? Because you are your children's covering. Praise God. Mm. Now, you just teach her to call on the name of Jesus. If things ain't right, they don't look right, just tell her, say Jesus.
Mm-hmm.
Say Jesus.
Yeah.
My little 4-year-old grandbaby watched me do sessions so much.
Mm-hmm.
And when something get wrong with her mother, the cross here, she called it Jesus.
Mm-hmm.
She grabbed Jesus, which is his cross, and she go to her mother and put it on her forehead. She always put it in the spot her mother having a problem with. She put it on her forehead, her stomach, and she say, Jesus. And then when we moved to this new apartment and she went in the bathroom by herself, me and my daughter was in the front room and we heard her in the bathroom say, in Jesus' name, get out, in Jesus' name, out, in Jesus' name. And my daughter and I, we looked at each other, just said, and she came out and the Lord told me, said, a demon was in the bathroom with her.
Oh,
and she cast it out.
Oh, wow.
In that new apartment.
Oh, my goodness.
Mm-hmm.
Wow.
So you have to show your children these things. Starting with your Victoria and your other two. Show them these things by your action and your reaction.
Yeah.
You think they're not observing and watching? Yes, they are.
Mm-hmm.
You teach them. Call on the name of Jesus. Say, look, after this, look, baby, I love you. Jesus still love you, too. You can check, he still love you. But me and Jesus want you to know.
Mm-hmm.
When those spirits come and torment you, just call on Jesus.
Okay.
Just call on his name, and he will help you.
Wow.
You teach them that. I taught mine that. They didn't think they never needed it, but they found out later.
Mm-hmm.
I know they called on Jesus. But you tell them that, you teach them that.
Okay.
So you stay blessed, and I continue
Thank
to keep
you.
Prayer.
Thank you, Jesus.
Okay.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
You're welcome.
You be blessed as well.
You too, sisters.
Okay.
Stay blessed now. Shalom.
All right. Shalom. Okay.